Hello students, welcome to biology classes. For class 12, in this video, I am going to discuss about the next concepts of the chapter, human health and diseases. Okay. So in previous videos, we studied about various diseases, so like the immune system of the body, then and HIV, then multiplication of HIV virus, then cancer, and we have completed the aspects of diseases. And have completed the aspects of immune system of the body. So from this class, we will talk about the next concepts like the adolescence, the drugs, the different kinds of drugs. So then drug addiction and drug abuse, and how to overcome the drug addiction and drug abuse, and what are the effects of drug abuse, then alcoholism and smoking. So effects of alcoholism and smoking, all of these are the next concept in this chapter, that is in human health and diseases. Okay, so now for this video, I'm going to talk about a concept what is called as adolescence. Adolescence. Okay. Adolescence is nothing but it is a period of extreme turbulence. So that is 9 to 18 years in girls and 10 to 19 years in boys. Then now adolescence and the prodavaste andre gradual aagi andre balyavaste inda naveno balya yuvana prodavaste yuvana andre uddapya anta naven karithilla aa rithi so balyavaste inda complete aagi andre just childhood na complete maadi so where the young ones especially the boys and the girls so they stepped into adolescent age andre in this particular period in this particular duration or in this particular age so where the extreme turbulences that is observed extreme turbulence means extremely disturbances are going to so like there are certain conditions so mental variations are going to be or athwa thumba craze iranta irbodu depression are going to be anxiety are going to be stress varabodu andre there are disturbing age especially the adolescent ages so lots of disturbances you will face those who are in the age between 10 to 18 years or 10 to 19 years of the age. Okay. So this is the age so where you can create any wonder because once you stepped into this adolescent age so once you set your goal okay, you can concentrate on that and you can create anything wonder. Suppose if you concentrated on other aspects which are surrounding you andre namma sutta iruvanta vere bad things anta nave karithivalla adakke surroundings ge so attract aagare again another terms you can create a blunder okay andre this is a very important age in the life cycle of any human being yade human being adu adolescent age anta idella that is very very important yaake andre ee particular age alline so ondu any kind of attraction so it may be the sexual attractions or whatever it may be the attractions or craze so that will be increased chances of addicted into particular drugs like smoking or chewing tobacco so then other taking other drugs like intravenous drugs so attracting towards other things some bad habits okay all those things the chances will be more in this particular age okay hence this age will decides the future of any individual suppose if this age it is utilized properly okay while setting our goal concentrating towards the goal then in studies if you are concentrated in that in this particular age you can create anything and that will decide your future especially if you become addicted to any kind of addictions like the drugs or any other bad habits if you are addicted to some kind of bad habits so again the future will be affected hence the extreme turbulences or the disturbances that can be seen in this age that is what is called as the adolescent age in this particular age a boy or a girl will be stepped into the next phase in their life cycle in their life that is the maturation of the reproductive organs in the body. So in adolescent age particularly, so where the gonads development and gonads reproduction, the maturation that will take place in this age, then lots of physical and physiological and psychological changes that takes place. Physical changes, it may include the physical changes, then physiological changes and psychological changes. So all of them that takes place in this particular age, e adolescent age, really physically changes occur. There are lots of physical changes takes place in the body. So like males and that, like development of hairs in the face, okay, that is the development of beard, okay, development of chest hairs, development of hairs in the underarm, then development of hairs in the pubic regions. And this particular age, the male start producing the semen. It is the sperms are produced inside the testicles of the male. So they are it means the overall secondary sexual characters in the male, it is initiated. So thereby the physical features of the male that start developing, the rapid growth that can be observed, the muscles in the body, they will be developed because of the secretion of testosterone hormone. So mainly it is under the influence of hormones. So physical changes that takes place under the influence of hormones, and even because of that the physiological changes also. So physical changes, as I said, you know, the male or the female will be stepped into or start producing the secondary sexual characters. So secondary sexual characters will be observed both in males as well as in females. So in females, there will be development of breast is observed, then development of pubic hairs, underarm hairs, all those things that is observed in females, that is as a sign of secondary sexual character. And the secondary sexual characters are the signs of maturity. It means a boy or a girl stepped into reproductive maturity. The gonads and the reproductive organs, they start maturing and they start developing. And now at this particular age, a male or a female, it means a boy or a girl, start producing the gametes. At that time, there are lots of physical and physiological changes they will take place. And when it comes to psychological changes, so if this is a particular period, so where the most of the mood swings will take place. Sometimes you will be very excited and sometimes you will be very depressed. Sometimes you will feel very stressed because it may be due to your academics or other things, you will be stressed. Then anxiety that can be observed. Some psychological disorders that may occur in this particular age. Yeah, the moods mood will change after that. In nature, childhood days will be adolescent age will be, so there are lots of changes. You cannot make particular decisions. Okay. And another thing, you will require a self-identity. Andre yaru particular age adolescent age alli iruttaro avrige ond self-identity na find out maartta iruttaru. So what is my identity in the society? They are searching for that. And they need self boosting way. So that is the thing in the adolescent age particularly. Athwa you will find towards a craze, you will attract towards a craze. Either you are attracted towards the opposite sex, or you are attracted towards the things which are found in your surroundings. Okay, so like you cycling irbodu, athwa bike ride madodu irbodu, vehicle ride madodu irbodu. So craze thumba speed ride madantu irbodu. So that craze will be seen in this particular age. Or you may be attracted towards some bad habits like the drugs, smoking. Okay, so like yaro oppa friend yaro smoke maartta idare anta smoking attract aagirabodu, athwa yaro elders smoke maartta idare, so how it will be yatra irabodu adu nanake adike attract aagutte irabodu. So all those psychological changes that takes place in this particular period, so that is what is called as the adolescence. Okay, so it is a period of extreme turbulence, because major reason because lots of physical changes that takes place in your body. Then physiological changes that takes place due to secretions of some particular hormones, they were not present in your childhood days, but once you hit these particular age, secretions of some hormones like progesterone, estrogen in females, then testosterone in males. Okay, so they will making the body to change. Some physical appearances will change, then the voice structure will change. Okay, so lots of changes will take place in this particular age. So that is what is called as the adolescent. Okay, and in this age, the person, the individual, they may have acne. Acne is nothing but, so common name of pimples on the perimeter. So that is majorly because of the blockages of pores which is formed on the skin by means of the hormones like testosterone. So where the pimples may appear in the face, and that is what is called as acne. Okay. Then lots of mood swings that is observed. So there are sudden changes in your mood. So mood swings that were observed. So lots of changes that is observed in your mood. So the ego you are the ego that the one mood next thing on 5 minutes, 10 minutes, then half an hour later go. Either you are attracted towards studies. Okay. So you also attract towards the achievements. You also attract towards the goals, the studies, everything. At the same time, the chances of attracting towards the other things like the bad habits, that will be also more. So that's why I said you can create a wonder or you can create a blunder in this age. So lots of mood changes or mood swings that takes place in this particular age. So someone needs counseling. So those who are having abnormal psychological behavior, psychological effects, so our counseling requirements are for each particular age, and not for all, but for someone who was specified with lots of anxiety, lots of stress, and lots of confusions, counseling. Okay. But once you pass this age, you know, you will become an adult. So this is an adolescent age, right? Childhood in the adolescent, adult age conversion. Once you pass this age, you will become an adult. So you know what are your responsibilities, you know which is good and which is bad. Okay. You will be able to decide, you will be able to take your own decisions. So then you are said to be, you are called as an adult. Okay. But behind that age, adult, after 20, 21 years, so at that time you will call as an adult. But behind that, you are in adolescent age. Okay. So this is about the adolescence. And the next thing is drug and drug addiction. Okay, so this is the next concept. So a drug is nothing but any chemical compound. A drug is any chemical compound having the ability to change or alter the physical, physiological and psychological nature or behavior of a person. Physical, physiological or psychological nature or behavior of a person. So that is what is called as a drug. A drug is any chemical substance or a compound. It is any chemical substance. Any chemical substance or a compound that is having the ability to change or alter the physical, physiological and psychological nature of a person. And then, yava ondu particular chemical compound, athava chemical substance, if we consume that chemical substance is having the ability to change our body's physical nature, then physiological effects, it causing some physiological effects and is causing some psychological effects, and that chemical is what is called as a drug. Okay. So a person without taking any drug, his body's conditions, the physical, physiological and psychological conditions will be normal. But when person consumes any drug, either it is intravenous drug or it is either smoke or it is chewed or taken orally, tablets orally body inject intravenous drugs again. So, or it may be smoked, like in case of cigarettes. So, that particular chemical compound, once it enters into our body, that is having the ability to change our perceptions. Perceptions and then our moods will change, our mental attitude change, our psychological condition change, physiological condition change, then physical nature that changes. And that particular chemical compound is what is called as a drug. So, drug basically it will be used for treatment basically, but later on andre now clinically suggest madiravashtu concentration alli consume madare avaga adu treatment ge andre drug aagi use madabodu, but yavudanna now excess aagi like more than the concentration which is clinically approved andre clinically approved concentration enirutta adikinta excess aagi tagondaga it will become an addiction. Okay, it will creates a dependency and that is what is called as a drug addiction. Adana now drug addiction anta kare andre consuming any drug prescribed more than prescribed than the clinical concentration. Clinical concentration prescribed madirodakkinta hechagi consume madre adana now addict anta kare. Addict andre consuming more amount of drug. Okay, and that is what is called as a drug addiction. So drug is any chemical substance. So that is having the ability to change our physical, physiological, and psychological effects or behaviors of the body is called as a drug. Okay. So drug addiction is nothing but condition where taking a drug, condition by taking a drug or combination of drugs beyond prescribed or clinically as prescribed. For example, there are lots of drugs, chemicals, they were used in many medicines. For example, in the cough syrups in madre cough syrup actually a narcotic drugs are used madtare with a very little concentration andre adike iste concentration use madbeku, it should not exceed anadu irutte ade particular concentration use madaga adu medicine age act madutte yavaga concentration jaasti agutto avaga em madutte body nalli lots of changes na induce madtare. Okay, so drugs beyond the prescribed अथवा क्लिनिकल कॉन्सेंट्रेशन बियॉन्ड प्रिस्क्राइब कॉन्सेंट्रेशन एंड दैट चेंजेस द परसेप्शंस ऑफ द बॉडी ऑफ द पर्सन चेंजेस द परसेप्शंस ऑफ द पर्सन. ओके, सो दैट इज व्हाट इज कॉल्ड एज ड्रग एडिक्शन अदना नाउ ड्रग एडिक्शन अंत करेंगे. ओके, so drug addiction is nothing but a condition where taking a drug or combination of drug andre onde drug tagobodu illa combination of tagobodu beyond the prescribed concentration andre clinical concentration eshtu irutho ashte consume madutare andre normal medicines alli use martare tablets alli athwa syrups alli nave medicine anta consume martivalla avaga ond ishte concentration alli idanna use madbeku anta ond rule irutte ashte concentration alli use madirtare, but beyond that consume madutare in excess concentration that changes the perceptions of the person who takes the drug andre yaar drug na tagondirutare aa person alli perceptions na change madutare. Perception change agutte antandre body condition, physical conditions, physiological conditions, the perceptions of the body avaga helidanalla physical, physiological and psychological effects that will changes perceptions of the person, that is what is called as drug addiction. Adana now drug addiction anta kare. Okay, so in other simple terms are like drug addiction. A drug addiction is nothing but in simple term is a severe craving for anything that can interfere with normal functions of the body, a severe craving for anything that can interfere with normal functions of the body. Andre body normal functions jothege yavu interfere madutho adike severe age craving. Okay, a severe craving andre tumba adana hambalisuvantha, so yavana tumba hambalustina adana craving anta kare. Severe craving for anything that can interfere with the normal conditions of the body, normal functions of the body, so that is what is called as a drug addiction. So drug addiction that will leads to dependency. Dependency in terms of the body will always demand a particular drug, and the body, the physical and physiological conditions of the body, so that is totally dependent on that particular thing. And the particular drug that I consume, maadilla antandre nan body normal ah function maadalla, nan normal ah iralla, adu physiological conditions nan body la nidiyala annoshtu mattige dependency na create maadirutte. ನೀವು ಬೇಡ ಅಂದ್ರೂ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಬಾಡಿ ಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಸಪೋಸ್ ಈಗ ಇಲ್ಲೇ ಟೇಬಲ್ ಮುಂದೆ ಆ ಡ್ರಗ್ ಅನ್ನು ಇಟ್ಟು ಬೇಡ ನಾನು ತಗೊಳ್ಳಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಮೈಂಡ್ ಒಂದ್ಸಲ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರು, ಬಟ್ ಯುವರ್ ಬಾಡಿ ಡಿಮ್ಯಾಂಡ್ಸ್ ಮೋರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಮೋರ್, ದೆನ್ ಅಗೇನ್ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಟೇಕ್ ದ ಡ್ರಗ್. ಅಂದ್ರೆ ದೋಸ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಡ್ರಗ್ ಅಬ್ಯೂಸರ್ಸ್, ಯಾರು ಡ್ರಗ್ ಅಬ್ಯೂಸರ್ಸ್ ಇರ್ತಾರೆ ಅವರು, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ಮಚ್ ಕ್ರೇವಿಂಗ್, ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಒಂಥರ ಹಂಗರ್ನೆಸ್ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟ್ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ, ಹಸಿವನ್ನು ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟ್ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ. ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಟುವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಅ ಡ್ರಗ್, ನಾಟ್ ಟೆಲಿಂಗ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದ ಫುಡ್, ಟುವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಅ ಡ್ರಗ್ ಇಟ್ ಮೇ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟ್ಸ್ ಹಂಗರ್ನೆಸ್, a severe craving for anything, so that will interfere with the normal functions of the body. That is what is called as the drug addiction anta karigu, okay. And it will lead to dependency andre helidre depend agirutte body, so body always demands that particular chemical substance. That is what is called as the drug dependency, okay. So then the drugs can be called as psychoactive molecules antandre, so where they particularly acting on our central nervous system, so they particularly acting on the central nervous system, andre namma nervous system mele act madavantadu, adike namma perceptions change agutte, mood change agutte, sedativeness andre drowsiness athwa sleepy nidde bandaga agabodu, tale tirigidanga agabodu, andre ನಮ್ಮ ಮಾತಾಡುವಂತ ಮಾತು ಚೇಂಜ್ ಆಗ್ಬೋದು, ನಮ್ಮ ನಡವಳಿಕೆ ಚೇಂಜ್ ಆಗ್ಬೋದು. ಸೊ ಆಲ್ ದೋಸ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಯಾಕೆ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಮೇಜರ್ ಆಗಿದೆ ಸೈಕೋ ಆಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ದ ಎಫೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆನ್ ಅವರ್ ಸೆಂಟ್ರಲ್ ನರ್ವಸ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್, ನಮ್ಮ ಸೆಂಟ್ರಲ್ ನರ್ವಸ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ಗೆ ಎಫೆಕ್ಟ್ ಅನ್ನ ಕಾಸ್ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ, ಅದನ್ನ ಸೈಕೋ ಆಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಡ್ರಗ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಕರೀತೀವಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ಲೂಡ್ಸ್ ತ್ರೀ ಕ್ಯಾಟಗರೀಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಸೈಕೋಟ್ರೋಪಿಕ್, another one narcotic, and another one psychedelic. Psychotropic, narcotic, and psychedelic. So the psychoactive drugs can be categorized into psychotropic, narcotic, and psychedelic drugs. Okay. So psychotropic drugs, they are the one which majorly known as sedatives or tranquilizers. Majorly known as sedatives or tranquilizers. TRANQI. Tranquilizers. So majorly psychotropic drugs are called as sedatives or tranquilizers. It means they depresses the central nervous system. Okay. It means they causing a soothing or calming effect on CNS. And the those persons who consume these drugs, it will cause us a soothing or a calming effect. And the namma anxiety na reduce maadi ontara calm effect na create maadanta drugs. So they are psychotropic drugs. They are sedatives or tranquilizers. Okay. Then the narcotic drugs. So narcotic drugs, they can act as the depressants. Depressants are the they decreases or depresses the activities of CNS. CNS activities to depress part of the depressants. Okay. So that is said to be the narcotic drugs. Depressants. Kami part of the. Then psychedelic drugs are the so they induces hallucinations. Psychedelic drugs induces hallucinations. Hallucination are the Brahma Dina are the ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಯಾವುದೋ ಒಂದು ಭ್ರಮೆನಲ್ಲಿ ಇರೋ ತರ ಆ ರೀತಿ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ಅಥವಾ ಆ ರೀತಿ ಎಫೆಕ್ಟ್ ನ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟ್ ಮಾಡುವಂತ ಡ್ರಗ್ಸ್ ಗೆ ನಾವು ಹ್ಯಾಲುಸಿನೇಷನ್ ಅಂತ ಕರೀತಾ ಪ್ರೋಸೆಸ್ ಗೆ ಹ್ಯಾಲುಸಿನೇಷನ್ ಅಂತೀವಿ. ಆ ಡ್ರಗ್ಸ್ ಗೆ ಸೈಕಡೆಲಿಕ್ ಡ್ರಗ್ಸ್ ಅಂತೀವಿ. ಸೈಕಡೆಲಿಕ್ ಡ್ರಗ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾಲುಸಿನೋಜನ್ಸ್. ಅದನ್ನು ನಾವು ಹ್ಯಾಲುಸಿನೋಜನ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಸೈಕಡೆಲಿಕ್ ಆರ್ ಹ್ಯಾಲುಸಿನೋಜನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ದ they induce hallucinations andre pramadina anta kareethivala adana hallucinations anta kareethivi okay so these are the three kinds of psychoactive drugs it means they majorly act upon our central nervous system so they are psychoactive drugs okay so in that the first one first group is sedatives so sedatives are the drugs they particularly induces drowsiness or sleeping they particularly induces drowsiness or sleeping andre tara vampro bandanga agutha drowsiness andre sleeping andre niddena induce madavanta drugs yadu the sedatives okay so suppose hyperactive idre so andre they usually release mental irritability na reduce madodakke overcome madodakke use madanta drugs na na sedatives anta treatment alli use martare but excess aagana matra drug abuse aagutte okay so sedatives are the drugs which is used to overcome mental irritabilities andra mental disturbances idre adanna relieve madodakke use madanta drugs na sedatives anta so they induce drowsiness or sleep andre ee nidde baruttilla tumbha yojanegalu irutte so antavalli so sleep na induce madanta drugs adanna sedatives anta okay so because of tension or anxiety so those who are having lack of sleep in such cases sedatives will be prescribed but usually yaru illa prescribe madala higher concentration alli except without prescription by a doctor okay so and one of the examples like barbiturates example like barbiturates so barbiturates are the sedatives okay and it is used in sleeping pills drowsiness na induce madutte anno kaarane so they are nothing but the sedatives they overcome mental irritability okay then the next category is tranquilizers causes soothing or calming effect it causes soothing or calming effect so these are the drugs which particularly reduces the anxiety or stress so these days you know we are facing so much of stress and so much of anxiety it may be for working professionals there will be work stress work and family balance stress for students there is a stress between the family as well as with the your studies every person is having the anxiety as well as the stress school ig hogakke mogu shuruvadaginda shuruvagutte stress anu moguge beninde bag hakkadsodu school alli osodu mane bandu homework maadsodu matte tuition ig kalsodu adanna allinda shuruvagutte stress anu manushana jeevanadalli so because that will create enormous amount of anxiety so it is very much common for every human being stress is there on the person's habitla almost okay because it is common in these situations what we face okay and the drugs which can be used to overcome anxiety or stress they are what is called as the tranquilizers and these tranquilizers they induces or which causes soothing or calming effect so yaar tranquilizer na consume maadtaro avaru tara soothing or calming effect na create maadtaru okay so they are the tranquilizers so for example reserpine idu one example sakashi idare tranquilizers so reserpine this is an alkaloid extracted from rauvia serpentina extracted from rauvia serpentina it means sarpagandhi anta kerivala adu so where it is an alkaloid extracted from rauvia serpentina that is reserpine the next thing is about narcotics. The next group of drugs are called as narcotics. And in narcotics, you have one in your syllabus, that is opioids. See, opioids are the narcotic drugs. Narcotic drugs are related depressants. It decreases the activities of central nervous system. Depressants. So, or they can be also used as the analgesics. Analgesic are the pain relievers are used. Or the sedatives are used. That is narcotics. Among that, one example is opioids. So, narcotics are the sedatives. They may induce sedativeness, sedatives, and majorly analgesic and depressants. So they may use as sedatives, analgesics, and depressants. Depressants are used for that. Other than that, narcotics. So the analgesic are pain relievers. Pain relieving. Pain relief. Okay, so pain relief madadana analgesic ante kareethi. So without causing the loss of consciousness, andre consciousness enu loss aagdene pain relief madadre antadana analgesic ante kareethi. Andre pregnant agine aagdene pregnant tappadene pain relief anta adana analgesic ante. Okay, so commonly the narcotics, the best example enna paanadre the opioids are the best example for the narcotics. So opioids are the groups of alkaloids. Group of alkaloids extracted from unripened capsule of papaver somniferum. Okay, so this is a plant. So e part you will get 1 mark ki 1 question per. Opioids are extracted from anta kelthare avaga plant name bayu scientific name of the plant bayu. This is a plant product. Opioids are the plant products, and opioids are nothing but a group of alkaloids. They were extracted from unripened capsules of papaver somniferum. Capsule is a fruit. Unripened fruits in the crystals formally latex formally varthe adana later en maartare adana crystals formally convert maartare. So opioids are nothing but the group of alkaloids, the latex extracted from the unripened capsules of papaver somniferum. Papaver somniferum plant inda adre ganja anta kelthirala adu papaver somniferum plant inda unripened capsules inda extract madanta alkaloids ge yen anta kelthare opioids anta kelthare. Okay, so basically helthara they can be used basically as analgesics, they can be used basically as depressants, or they can be used as sedatives. And there are semi-synthetic opioids who are available in the market. Semi-synthetic by treating them with certain chemicals, are completely synthetic opioids are also available in the market, and in minimum concentration, so they were used as a drugs. It means for the treatment of various diseases. So basically they were used in the treatment of vomiting, in the treatment of diarrhea, they were used in the treatment of vomiting, in the treatment of diarrhea. Okay. So, and they were used in cough syrups. In little concentration, in a very minimum concentration. So they were used for treatment. But when this concentration exceeds, you know, when we consume these particular substances in an excess of concentration, that will become a drug addiction. That is become a drug abuse. Okay. So some semi-synthetic compounds of opioids like morphine, then codeine. So these are some of the semi-synthetic alkaloids which are extracted from opioids. Similarly, heroin, so commonly known as brown sugar. So which is commonly brown sugar anta karigala adu. Heroin is extracted by treating morphine. Idana 1 mark se kelthare how heroin is produced anta 1 or 2 mark se kelthare. Heroin is produced by treating morphine with acetic anhydride. anhydride. By treating morphine with acetic anhydride, it will become diacetyl morphine. Diacetyl morphine. So this diacetyl morphine is commonly known as heroin. Diacetyl morphine is commonly called as the heroin. Okay. So the cultivation of these plants is an offense. It is a criminal offense. These plants are cultivated under without license. Exception. ಯಾವುದಕ್ಕೆ ಟ್ರೀಟ್ಮೆಂಟಲ್ಲಿ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡೋದಾದ್ರೆ ಮಾತ್ರ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಾಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು, ಬಟ್ ಕಲ್ಟಿವೇಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ಅನ್ ಅಫೆನ್ಸ್, ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಲೀಗಲ್ ಅಫೆನ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಬಟ್ ದೀಸ್ ಡ್ರಗ್ಸ್ ದ ಓಪಿಯಾಯ್ಡ್ಸ್ ದೇ ವರ್ ಕನ್ಸ್ಯೂಮ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಅನ್ ಎಕ್ಸೆಸಿವ್ ಕಾನ್ಸಂಟ್ರೇಷನ್ ಐದರ್ ಥ್ರೂ ದ ಓರಲ್ ವೇಸ್ ಆರ್ ಬೈ ಇಂಜೆಕ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಥ್ರೂ ದ ಇಂಟ್ರಾವಿನಸ್ ವೇಸ್ ಆರ್ ಐದರ್ ಬೈ ಸ್ಮೋಕಿಂಗ್. ಓಕೆ, ಅಂದರೆ ಡ್ರಗ್ ಅಬ್ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡೋರು ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು, ಸ್ಮೋಕ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ, ಅದಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಇಂಟ್ರಾವಿನಸ್ ಇಂಜೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಸಿರಿಂಜಸ್ನ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಇಂಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು, ಅದಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ, ಸೊ ಸ್ಮೋಕ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು, ಇಲ್ಲ ಓರಲಿ ಕನ್ಸ್ಯೂಮ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಆಲ್ ದೋಸ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ದೇವರ್ ಇನ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಬ್ಯೂಸ್, ಡ್ರಗ್ನ ಕನ್ಸ್ಯೂಮ್ ಮಾಡೋದು, ಅಬ್ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡೋದು. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಹೆನ್ಸ್ ದ ಓಪಿಯಾಯ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದೇ ಕಾಸಸ್ ದ ಸೆಡೇಟಿವ್ನೆಸ್, ದೇ ಕಾಸಸ್ ದ ಅನರ್ಜೆಸಿಕ್, ಇಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ರಿಲೀವ್ಸ್ ಅ ಪೇನ್, ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಡಿಪ್ರೆಸಸ್ ದ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟೀಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಸೆಂಟ್ರಲ್ ನರ್ವಸ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್, ಸೆಂಟ್ರಲ್ ನರ್ವಸ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟೀಸ್ ನ ಡಿಪ್ರೆಸ್ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ವೆನ್ ದೇ ವರ್ ಕನ್ಸ್ಯೂಮ್ ಓರಲಿ, ಇದನ್ನು ಓರಲಿ ಕನ್ಸ್ಯೂಮ್ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗ ಅಥವಾ ಇಂಟ್ರಾವಿನಸ್ ಡ್ರಗ್ಸ್ ಆಗಿ ಇಂಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗ ಅಥವಾ ಸ್ಮೋಕ್ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗ, ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಕಾಸಸ್, ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ರೆಡ್ಯೂಸಸ್ ಬಿ ಪಿ, ಪರ್ಸನ್ಸ್ ಮೇ ಬಿ ಲೋ ಬಿ ಪಿ, ದೆನ್ ಡಿಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟೀಸ್, ಡಿಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಸಮ್ಟೈಮ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಮೇ ಲೀಡ್ಸ್ ಟು ಕಾರ್ಡಿಯಾಕ್ ಅರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಎಫೆಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಇರ್ತಾರೆ, ಕಾರ್ಡಿಯಾಕ್ ಅರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಆಗ್ಬೋದು, ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟೀಸ್ ಡಿಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಆಗ್ಬೋದು, ದೆನ್ ಡ್ರೌಸಿನೆಸ್, ಮಂಕ್ರು ಡ್ರೌಸಿನೆಸ್, ಇಟ್ ಮೇ ಯೂಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸೆಸ್ ಕನ್ಸ್ಯೂಮ್ಷನ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ, ಇಟ್ ಮೇ ಯೂಸ್ ಸ್ಲೀಪಿಂಗ್, ದೆನ್ ಸೀವಿಯರ್ ಕ್ರೇವಿಂಗ್, ಸೀವಿಯರ್ ಕ್ರೇವಿಂಗ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಆ ಡ್ರಗ್ಗಿಗೆ, ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಡ್ರಗ್ಗಿಗೆ ಕ್ರೇವಿಂಗ್ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಆಗ್ಬೋದು, ಸೀವಿಯರ್ ಕ್ರೇವಿಂಗ್. ಓಕೆ, ಇಟ್ ಮೇ ಯೂಸ್ ವಾಮಿಟಿಂಗ್, ಇಂಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ವಾಮಿಟಿಂಗ್. ಸೊ ವಾಮಿಟಿಂಗ್ ಟ್ರೀಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು ಎಕ್ಸೆಸ್ ಕನ್ಸಂಪ್ಷನ್ ಆದ್ರೆ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಇಂಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ವಾಮಿಟಿಂಗ್, ಮೇ ಇಂಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಡಯೇರಿಯಾ, ಮೇ ಇಂಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಡಯೇರಿಯಾ. ಸೊ ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಲಾಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಸೈಡ್ ಎಫೆಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ದೇರ್ ಒನ್ಸ್ ದೀಸ್ ಓಪಿಯಾಯ್ಡ್ಸ್ ವರ್ ಕನ್ಸ್ಯೂಮ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಎ ಲಾರ್ಜರ್ ಕ್ವಾಂಟಿಟೀಸ್ ಆಸ್ ಎ ಡ್ರಗ್ ಅಬ್ಯೂಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ ಓಪಿಯಾಯ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಎ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಲ್ಕಲಾಯ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಾಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಅ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಪಪಾವರ್ ಸೋಮನಿಫೆರಮ್. ಓಕೆ, ಫ್ರಮ್ ದ ಅನ್ರೈಪಡ್ capsules of papaver somniferum the latex is extracted and that latex is used for the manufacture of the drugs. Okay. And basically used in the treatment, the excess concentration will become a drug abuse, a drug addiction. Okay. They were consumed in case of drug addiction in by intravenous, the inject madodinda irbodu, oral irbodu, smoke alli irbodu, consume madidre, so they will cause these effects. Okay. So this is about opioids, they are the narcotic drugs and they were extracted from papaver somniferum. Okay, so in next video I will come up with the next group of drugs, that is speeders or uppers, then the drugs can induce us hallucination and the effect of smoking and effect of alcoholism. So that we will discuss in the next class.